There's a dark side to love and romance that often gets overlooked around Valentine's Day. The CDC estimates that more than 30% of adolescent girls have been abused either physically, verbally, or emotionally by a dating partner. Something that Eve Ensler, author of The Vagina Monologues, has fought against for the past 10 years. And it is just one of the topics addressed in her new book, which is called I Am an Emotional Creature. And Eve joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
I love this book. I have a daughter.
Thank you.
And I know that you wrote all these monologues about girls to kind of take us inside the minds of girls. One of the things you talk about is domestic violence. What have you learned in your conversations with girls around the world about this topic?
Well, it seems to me that there is much more violence going on in the teenage world than we thought, and that many more girls are getting beat up or slapped or kicked and violated in some essential way than we knew about. And I think it's all connected to a larger theme, which I hope the book is addressing, which is girls having rights and girls knowing their rights and girls feeling good about themselves. I think over the last 10 years, I've had the great fortune to travel around the world and with V-Day, the global movement to end violence against women and girls. And I've seen girls in all kinds of different circumstances in many, many countries. And I think if there's one theme that's kind of connecting them all, it's this mandate in every culture to please, to please, to do what somebody else, whether it's the culture or the religion or parents or friends or boyfriends, want girls to do.
To be a stereotypical girl.
Right, or just to do what somebody else wants.
Right, right.
And I think staying in a violent relationship is about doing what the boy wants, not what you want. And I think the book is looking at how that mandate is put on girls, but how girls also resist that mandate throughout the world.
One of the monologues in your book is written in the form of a letter, Dear Rihanna. Of course, Rihanna, the singer who was famously involved in an abusive relationship with Chris Brown, and I want to read an excerpt. You're so strong, Rihanna. I watch you in the videos. You look right into the camera. You are so much stronger. You could help Chris. When something so terrible happens to someone so public, how can we use this as a tool to teach our daughters?
Well, I think that was a really interesting experience just culturally, because I think many girls, I was reading a lot of the blogs and what girls were writing in, and half the girls were like, get out, it's a terrible thing. But a lot of girls were writing, you know, how can you possibly think about leaving? He did one thing wrong, you can't. And I started to think about girls, how we have this capacity as women to feel what somebody else isn't feeling. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we feel what boys feel or what men feel because they've been so disallowed to have their feelings. And I think often when girls stay with boys, it isn't always because they want to be beat up. It's because they're feeling their sorrow or they're feeling their insecurity or they're feeling their grief or they're feeling something boys don't feel. So they're overcompensating for that. And I think that's an asset that girls have. How we negotiate that and how girls take care of themselves with that asset is a really important thing to be thinking about.
I liked every monologue, but maybe my favorite thing in the book was the epilogue. I'd like to read a little bit of it. It's a manifesto to young women and girls, and you write, here's what you will be told. Find a man, seek protection, the world is scary, don't go out, you are weak, don't care so much, don't be so intense, don't cry so much, you can't trust anyone. And then you write what you're telling girls that they should be doing. Will you read it?
Everyone's making everything up. There is no one in charge except for those who pretend to be. Always fight back, ask for it, say you want it, cherish your solitude, take trains by yourself to places you've never been, sleep out under the stars, and learn how to drive a stick shift.
And it goes on and on. Thank you, Eve, for everything you do to empower young
women.
Thank
you so much.
This book goes a long way to that end, so please get it. I'm an emotional creature.